Stella, I vow to spend every second of every moment of the rest of my life loving and honoring you. I vow to be by your side, on your team, and walking with you through whatever seasons come. Through hardship or heartache, I will not leave you.
I promise to love you as you are, and not try to change you, but to build you up and encourage you to be the man that you want to be, supporting you always and cheering you on.
With this covenant, I vow to be faithful to you and you alone, to make decisions with you, to respect you, to protect you and take care of you.
I promise to walk alongside you in your faith, to never judge you or to tear you down, but to love you as Jesus loves us, with patience, forgiveness, and sacrifice. Stella, you are more beautiful than I can even explain. You care so deeply for people and go the extra mile to help and love everyone.
Just all that you do, the cornerstone and identity of who you guys are as a couple and as individuals is through your relationship with Jesus. And it's so evident in how you guys live your lives and how you give to others.
I'm so lucky to have a friend like you. And I'm so happy you got to marry your best friend. I wish you both a lifetime of joy and happiness together.
And we see the new sun rising over the hills on the horizon. There's gold in them hills. There's gold in them.
Beauty is formed and forged in marriage by staying the course in the highs and lows and a lot of sacrificial and selfless love. It takes work, albeit good work, to see this beauty come to pass. It is within this give and take dance that marriage finds a fertile ground for growth and flourishing. Remember, you're a team. What is happening today, you're blending your lives together. Try to learn to harmonize your own needs, your own goals, your dreams in a way that adds values to you both together as a team. The true key to weathering every season that life brings your way is to keep God the center of it all. No matter what season you find yourselves in, Matt and Stella, by anchoring God at the center of your both your lives, making him the bedrock of your marriage, you'll not only endure, but you'll triumph.
Matthew, I knew I was going to marry you the night we first met. It might sound crazy, but for some reason, without even knowing you at all, there was a voice inside of me saying he's going to be your husband someday. And I thank God for that voice every day.
I vow to always be a listening ear for you, to be someone you can trust and confide in, to listen in order to understand. I vow to admit when I'm wrong, to apologize when I make a mistake.
Ecclesiastes tells us about the futility of worldly possessions and temporary pleasures, and says that God has placed eternity in our hearts. And so with that in mind, Matthew, I vow to love and care for you through all of life's eternal moments.
I vow to raise children with you, to be the best husband and father that I can be for our family.
Loving you is so easy, and it's the greatest blessing of my life. I promise to be there for you, even when life, isn't as easy as loving you is. I promise to be your wife, today, tomorrow, and for eternity. I love you.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I declare this now. This is Ellie and Matthew and Stella Rose.
Matt, I'd like to first of all welcome you to the family. We welcome you with open arms. We're certainly delighted that Stella found you.
You're fiercely competitive, which I love, and you make life more fun. You inspire me to be a better person, and you taught me how to use my beauty blender products.
Matt, it's been fantastic seeing you grow into a man. Seeing you, you challenge yourself, you're creative, you're passionate, you're independent, and you're very goal-focused, man. What an amazing couple you are, you two. You're a blessing to each other, and a blessing to us.
However long you say, how long will I love you? As long as stars are above.